Okay, everybody, welcome back to Learn with Minecraft Education. We are today looking at classroom mode, which is a way of keeping track of some of your students if they're hosting worlds with each other, or in this case, if you're hosting a world for them. So I've hosted a world and asked one of my colleagues to join that world. I'm going to look at loading up classroom mode. Now, classroom mode you can find in the Minecraft website, so give it a little search and it will pop up. And it's a separate piece of software that runs adjacently to the regular Minecraft education. And when you load it up, it should look a bit like this. Now, these are some of the servers that are currently running, some of the worlds that are being created by students on our network. But what I want to do is I want to add my own world to this one. So we're going to go to Waiting Room, and we're going to copy this command. We're going to head back over to Minecraft and paste that into the chat box. There we go. And now if I head over to classroom mode, it's jumped me straight into that world, okay? So first thing we can do is navigate around this map. So as you can see, we've got the two Roberts in here, and Robert C down here is doing some building, and Robert F, that's me, is the host. So there's a few things we can do. In the top left here, we can change a lot of these settings. So we can pause the game for all the players. We can disable chat. We can make the weather perfect all the time. We can allow mobs. We can turn on or off destructive items, turn on or off player damage, prohibit world modification so that players can't mine or destroy any things that you've placed in the world, and allow players to damage each other. We can turn that on and off. One of the other useful things you can do in classroom mode is you can move characters around. So if we want both of these players to work on a new structure or a new activity that you've created over here, just right click on that part of the map and teleport all here, and both the players are going to move over to this area. If you want to move one of these players, so we'll move Robert C back to his building over here, then you left click and hold on their name and drag over to where they were there and just let go, and it will place them again, just where you want them to go. Now, you can also go into the chat. You can enter commands to change the weather, to move people to specific coordinates and things like that. So there's a lot of things you can do in classroom mode, and it's a really good way for managing your students and the worlds that they create. Now, please do like and subscribe to these videos. There's going to be lots of upcoming ones on this topic. Just a short one today, though, introducing classroom mode. So thanks for tuning in, and do download this and check it out.